Michael Bisping, one of the toughest guys to ever step foot in the cage, one of the toughest men alive right now, does not live life with regret. And he came out on his show and he said that he had regret for taking the Kelvin Gastelum fight. Now, I believe him. I didn't know why the hell he took that fight, when he took that fight. But let me just remind you guys of what he's referring to. Okay, he had a mega fight against George St. Pierre for the world championship. Bisping's world championship. Bisping put it on the line. Bisping doesn't have the easiest time making 185 pounds, which is very relevant to the story. Because the Gastelum fight was 3 weeks after he lost the belt. So now you're talking about not only the physical druthers of being in there with George St. Pierre, roughly 15 minutes. You also have the emotional letdown of no longer being the champion of the world. So to even be asked to take a fight on 3 weeks' notice, I mean, I would suspect before they made that phone call to Michael, they probably thought, yeah, we're going to get a no, but let's get the no and then we can move on. Hey, I'll call him right now. You guys come up with two more names. Bisping says yes. I mean, you wouldn't even ask a guy who went through what he went through 3 weeks later to fly to a different country. By the way, that fight was in a different country. I want to say Japan. That's off the top of my head. Definitely in a different country. I remember that much. And then go take on a hammer, a younger up-and-coming ultimate fighter winning Kelvin Gastelum. You just want to do that. Now, a little tiny bit of a backstory there is Kelvin and Bisping had worked out together at some point. The thing I would suspect that Bisping probably remembered that workout and say, oh, yeah, I'll be fine. I'll go take on that fight. The one problem there is what I just laid out. He's on a letdown. Physically, he's diminished. That fight took a lot out of him. Emotionally, he's diminished. And Kelvin Gastelum doesn't go very hard in practice. That's one of the tricks. He just doesn't. Kelvin Gastelum will go as hard as you want to go, but he'll always let you make the choice, which is why he's so damn deceptive. At any rate, that's a little bit of a sidebar, but it's something that I was armed with. I had trained with Kelvin. I had competed with Michael, and I remember when he took that fight, knowing what he was going through. I've had those highs and those lows. I just understood it. Now he's got to make weight again while going to be jet-lagged in a foreign country. Oh, and by the way, it's a main event. It could go 25 minutes. He bit off just too much more than he could chew. It was a sign of his toughness, his mental toughness, his competitiveness. There are all sorts of praise you could give Bisping, but in hindsight, is not where you can see how this fight ends. You could see how this fight ends as soon as they said this fight was going to happen 3 weeks after he got in the cage with George St. Pierre. Okay. So he also talked about that St. Pierre fight. He said, look, St. Pierre knew I was blind in one eye, and he targeted that side. And it left me with two questions, two just personal internal questions. First off, did George know that? I would just be curious. Can we confirm that George knew that? I didn't know it. That didn't come out till later. Post-career, Michael's been very open to talk about it, even done some funny stuff with the eye and showed everybody. But what I'm saying is, did George know that? And secondly, if he did, would George be ethically wrong to go after that? And this is very heavy stuff. This is a very heavy topic, right? Eyes are amongst the most important thing. In my belief, there's one thing that can't be fixed. They just, science-wise, they just don't have a way to fix eyes yet, to replace eyes, right, of all your organs. So I bring that up because you're talking about something very sensitive, and I'm still left even the coldness of no. Now, I don't know how you would target an eye that was, I just personally don't have the skills to, I have a hard enough time finding a guy's head. Usually I would go to the body just because it was an easier target. So to find an eye, I don't have that skill. But if I did, would I use that? And I would think that when you're in a competition in front of the world where one man is trying to hurt you under the unified rules and you are trying to damage him under the unified rules, yeah, I think a guy would. I think if the roles were reversed and we just asked Michael, hey, Michael, if George had an ailment and you knew about it, would have you attacked it, yes or no? And I think Michael would probably smile and say, yes.